Last week, Mozilla made an announcement about a new browser that we are releasing. And it's new, but it's maybe not as new as you think, and I'll explain exactly how. We had this idea last year that to take the developer tooling that is available and extend that experience throughout the entire browser so that developers have an experience that is tailored to their needs specifically. And so what we've come up with and been working very hard on for the last few months is the Firefox Developer Edition. So hello. This is my first time in Budapest, actually. I was told that I'm not supposed to tell people that I'm Hungarian because I don't speak the language, and that's kind of embarrassing. But my mother is actually from here, and it's nice to be here for the first time. Of course, my name is Angelina Fabbro, and I am Hopeful Cyborg on Twitter. If you use Twitter, you can ask me questions there. And of course, I'm from Mozilla. Most recently, I was on the developer tools team, so I worked on this browser as well. Historically, like in my past, I've been writing web pages and applications since I was maybe 12 years old. So I've worked in a lot of different places, and I'm very happy to be a part of Mozilla working on these projects for the open web. I want to be clear, Mozilla really loves the support from Hungary. I know that we are quite a popular browser here, and because I'm in North America, I'm from Vancouver, Canada, right? We are not the most popular browser in North America, so when I travel, I think it's very nice to go to locations and see this huge Mozilla community, because in North America, I think that Chrome is the popular developer browser. But I think that if I do my job well, and if we do our job well on the developer tools team, that maybe that will not be true anymore. So this today is actually the first look. You are the first audience to have a talk about this topic. We released a very short teaser. Yes, you're exactly, this is the first time. Because when I was invited here, they asked me, OK, well, what would you like to speak about? I knew that this date, November 8th, was very close to the 10th by 2 days. And so I asked everybody at Mozilla, I said, you know, I think that since Hungary loves Mozilla and Mozilla loves Hungary, then maybe this should be the very first time that we show off this browser. So. And it was supposed to be the first, but then you know how the press is, right? The newspapers, they managed to get their hands on it, and they beat me to it. So maybe you've seen a few of these things. So before we look at the features of developer browser and how it is, you know, the same but different from existing Firefox and browsers out there, let's look a little bit at web tools and developer tools for the web and how we sort of got to where we are. Like, how did we get here? So I posted this tweet earlier this week, and I said, you know, I would like you, just for fun, tell me what tools you used to use before Firebug. Because Firebug created a significant change in the landscape of developer tooling. And of course, all the people that replied, the most popular response was actually that before all of the tools, they just used Alert. And me too. I did that too. I remember when CSS was still really new and I was just learning JavaScript and I was like a teenager skipping school in high school to go write code, which is actually what I did. The rest of it was a waste of time, but don't tell the kids that. You know, I remember using Alert, and you know, I think every web developer at some point when they were doing this got themselves into a state with a loop where it opened like, you know, 500 alerts and you have to force quit the browser. But thankfully, the web tooling has come a long way since then. Another popular answer was the web developer toolbar, which looked a little bit something like this, actually. This is actually a fairly recent iteration of the web toolbar, but that one is also pretty popular. And that originally started, I think it was a little before Firebug or around the same time. And it was sort of like the first, that was the first thing that I'd use before Firebug for debugging web applications. And this just changed everything for me. Being able to like look in detail in the markup in that kind of tree, that was a big game changer for how I thought about the code and the HTML and things that I was writing. Another one, maybe around, it's quite early, I think maybe 2001, was Venkman, which is another Mozilla tool, and this was a very early JavaScript debugger. As far as I know, it was the first of its time. And you can tell this is old because things have the XML extension. Yeah. But, so Venkman was another early tool as well. But 2006 was a very, very important year because 2006 was the year that Firebug was introduced. And although Firebug did not start as an official Mozilla project, and even to this day, Firebug still exists and is not an official project, it is very much tied with the history of Firefox. It was the popularity of this extension that for a time made Firefox and Firebug the most common set of developer tools that web developers were using. There was a time where that was the most popular. And so I want to talk about Firebug today because it still has millions and millions of users. And what we're doing with Firebug ties into what we're doing with developer tools and also with the browser. Firebug was the first to offer, of course, a very simple user experience showing you, you know, your markup in a hierarchy and developing CSS inspection and things like that. This is like Firebug 2 here, so I mean that was the original UI. It looks very familiar to me. It's exposed a lot of new audience to how the web works. Like, people found out that they could install this plugin and sort of get a visualization of what was behind the scenes. They didn't have to, you know, go and view source. They didn't have to use these other tools like Venkman and stuff like that. There was more opportunity for them to understand the web in a very fine detail behind the scenes. And Firebug actually truly shaped our browsers. At the very last Firefox Developer Tools Work Week, we invited the Firebug team to join us because actually Mozilla has been supporting Firebug. Even though it's not an official Mozilla project, we know this is very important to the developer community. But what I learned was actually that Firebug had a huge influence on the console API, for example. The HTTP archive for looking at your HTTP, and also graphical breakpoints. They were sort of like the first to do that, especially in the web code area. So they have had very, very big impact on the web. And the developer tools that we see today in Firefox and Chrome are largely influenced by this tool. And it still has millions of users. I don't know the exact number, but I think 3 or 4 million, which is a lot. I've been talking with the Firebug team and with, if you're familiar with Sencha, the web framework Sencha, I was talking to a guy there, and he was asking me to help him with the Sencha developers to show them more of the Firefox tools, because he said that most of the people that work with Sencha really like Firefox. And I said, oh, well, do they use the tools or do they use Firebug? And he said, actually, almost all of them use Firebug because people in the past have created Firebug extensions that are very, very particular to a framework or some specific task that they do at their company, so they stay with it for a long time. And the reason why I wanted to mention all of this is because Firebug 3 is coming, and the developer tools have caught up. There was a time when, Firebug was far ahead, and then Chrome introduced their tools, and Chrome became really popular, and so now, and then eventually Firefox was like, okay, well, you know, Chrome has their own native developer tools, maybe we should have some too. And over the past years, we've done a lot of work to catch up, and now all of the features in native Firefox developer tools have reached, you know, feature parity with what is in Firebug. So they pretty much have the same features. So working with the Firebug team on Firebug 3, Firebug 3 is going to continue to be an extension, but actually it will just be a layer that sits on top of the developer tools and doesn't duplicate functionality. Firebug 3 has always been an extension, so it makes sense to do things this way. And users do not want two tools that do the same thing. It doesn't make sense to have Firebug keep doing the DOM inspection sort of stuff when that's very clear that it works well in the developer tools. It just seems silly to install an extension that duplicates effort. So it is actually already integrated with our new debugger API and the remote debugging protocol. So we're progressing with that slowly. And so people might ask, you know, well, what about my Firebug extensions? Well, Firebug 3 is still going to exist as, you know, as this layer on top of the DevTools. So your Firebug extensions will definitely work as well. And I think that's very important so that people don't think that we're leaving them behind or that they need to worry about those features going away. The Firebug team seems very focused to me. Like, they seem very focused on making sure people have a very smooth experience. And I actually have this very, very brief video here. This is actually a sneak peek of Firebug 3. And it's a short video that actually I want to show you because one of the things that we've introduced in Firebug 3 is the ability to theme the Firefox developer tools with the Firebug theme. So if you are coming from Firebug and we want you to transition to the native Firefox developer tools, there is actually a theme that will make our developer tools look like Firebug. So it's easy for you and it doesn't break your workflow. I personally think that I don't want to use a tool that's going to break my workflow. So this video here was created by Jan, and Jan is one of the, I think he's the core developer on Firebug, but it's a lot of people. And I'll show you in just a moment here that we can turn off the Firebug theme and it looks back like the developer tools. So it's very simple for people, if you're someone in the audience who uses Firebug, it's very simple for you to make this transition to the developer tools because you can just use the Firebug theme without, you won't even know, it looks like the same thing. So there's that. Not a problem at all. I don't think you have anything to worry about, but we wanted to tell you this because, I don't know, whenever there's changes to my software, I get worried too. So what I think is pretty interesting about this whole story is that our developer tooling started as a browser extension, and then it's moved to built-in tooling, like in Firefox and Chrome. And now with the Firefox Developer Browser, which is what I'm running right now, you can tell by the modified UI at the top, the tooling has become a whole browser development experience. And I know that these changes mean being a little bit nervous. Like, what does it mean to have this new developer browser? A lot of people actually thought, I was reading the comments on the internet. You should never read the comments. They're only full of garbage. But I make mistakes. I read the comments. And people asking, like, oh, Mozilla is a big jerk for doing this because now we have another browser to support. But we love you. We don't want you left behind. And the thing is, it's the same great Firefox. It's the same Gecko underneath. The things that change are basically in the UI and the front end and the tooling. You're not supporting another rendering engine. We are not that mean. I think one day when our servo engine built in Rust actually becomes part of a browser somewhere, maybe we have a different conversation, but for now you have nothing to worry about. So people thought, I think, the wrong thing. So you don't need to worry, it is the same Firefox. This is the same rendering engine that the people using regular Firefox will have. So some of the things that we've got in this new developer release is that this replaces our old Aurora channel. So we have several channels of varying stability that introduce new features. And each new release of this developer browser will include features that have stabilized in nightly, but at least for 6 weeks before they enter the beta channel and 12 weeks before they ship in the main release. So this is a channel where it's not quite as unstable as nightly. I actually, until the developer browser came out, I would run nightly and just have all the bugs. I'm supposed to report all the bugs too that I find, so there's that. But it's a nice, I think, compromise because you get access to newer features like newer platform APIs and newer web APIs and also the developer tools before it goes into the stable channel, but it's not as buggy as nightly. I think it is a good compromise. And one of the other things is that this will always run on a separate profile. For me, I often need to run multiple versions of Firefox. Like sometimes I have one Firefox that I have like all my tabs open. Maybe I have like MDN and like Stack Overflow because I got some hard problem and I don't know how to solve it. And then because I'm working on the developer tools, I need to run a special build of the developer tools. And I need to, before I have to do all these like weird profile things. But now it's just easy because there's a separate profile and this can run alongside your regular Firefox, if you like. So there's that. This is actually the place where we will include experimental developer tools first. For example, one of the tools that comes bundled with the developer edition but does not come bundled with other Firefox, you can install it as an add-on, however, is a tool we've built called Valence. And hopefully this video will work. Let's take a look here. Oh, okay, it will. That's good. And so Valence is a plugin that allows you to remote debug targets other than Firefox. So in the past, it was actually you could remote debug Firefox OS and Firefox for Android. But earlier in the year, I made the argument, and other people made the argument too, it wasn't just me, saying that, okay, so I personally feel that Firefox developer tools should go where the web is. And that's not always Firefox. It's important to developers just to do their job every day and, you know, be able to make money and support themselves. And sometimes they, you know, and they need to make sure their application works everywhere. That means they need to test on iOS for Safari, on Chrome for Android. And so that is what this add-on and this feature in the developer browser will allow you to do. And just, this is a very, very short video of Brian Grinstead, who's also on the team, talking a little bit about Valence. Oh, no. It's because I went full screen, isn't it? Okay, well, that's not going to work. So maybe no full screen. He's so happy, I love it. Yes.
And you know the ID of the download button, so let me search for it. Then I'm gonna open this up. And let's change the text. There. I think we're gonna need a bigger button.
So that's just a very quick example of the feature. And even though we use the iOS simulator here, it works with a device connected. Like I can plug in my iPhone or my Firefox OS device or my Android device, and I can remote debug those on device. Because I'm sure, as you all know, nothing replaces on device testing. So I really like that. I think that that's very exciting. So if you're somebody who works in mobile development, it's nice to use one set of tools and not have to switch between all the different browsers in order to debug those or to do things like, has anyone here used Winery or Winery, the remote debugging tool? Okay, for a very long time, you could inject some JavaScript into your page, and you could actually you'd inject some JavaScript into your page on an iOS device, and then using WebSockets, it would give you some of the debug information, but you couldn't get all of the things that you would normally have with developer tools. And for a long time, that was actually how we had to debug stuff, like that even before iOS introduced its very crappy remote debugging tools. They're not very good. I really don't like them. So, as an example, that's the developer edition has this built in with the assumption that that's useful. We started with iOS and Android, and of course Firefox OS you can already do as well. And actually another thing is that you can actually use it to debug other browsers on your desktop. So when I was working on features there, I was actually working with the Chrome remote debugging protocol, and I was just using Chrome desktop. I didn't want to have my phone with iOS plugged in all the time or something. So you can actually like connect to other browsers too that can run. If you can open the browser with, say, remote debugging flag like you can with Chrome from the command line, you can use our tool to connect to whatever's running on port 922, I think, and just remote debug that if the protocol's there. So another thing is that we have some default preferences that are tailored for web developers. We've set some things on by default. For example, we sort of assume that if you are a developer, probably you're going to want to debug the Chrome, maybe. Probably you're going to want to do remote debug devices. And if you're running in the stable, regular version of Firefox, normally you have to go to about:config, and you have to go through all the preferences and configure all the new features that you want. With this version, we kind of set some of those things up for you, which is kind of nice because, I don't know, sometimes I meet developers and they ask me, Angelina, why doesn't this work? And we spend like 10 minutes trying to figure out why it doesn't work, only to realize that some stupid preference somewhere isn't set to true. So I think that makes that a little bit easier for developers, especially beginning developers that a lot of them assume that these things will just work and they don't know that they're turned off by default in the main browser. And of course, the other thing is that if you're looking here, we have a very distinct theme which allows you for quicker access to the developer tools. Not that it was particularly hard before, but why not make it a little bit easier? So, we have this menu here that allows us to toggle the tools on and off. You can get to, things like the responsive design view fairly easily. And then you've got the same great tools down here. And I mean, I themed my presentation, so it's like the nice same color and all of that. But the other thing that I like is that we've actually made the tabs up here a lot smaller and the UI up here a lot smaller. To me, I want these things to take up not a lot of space. I want, you know, the viewport and the tools on my screen when I'm working to be the things that are the most important. And we also have a shortcut here for Web ID too. Oh, I don't have Chrome open. It's trying to connect to it. But Web ID is something that I don't think many people are familiar with yet. How many people here have done some Firefox OS development? Okay, so the five of you are great. But Web IDE is actually, we have like a small an editor in there, and we have like this dashboard that if you're working on applications, allow you to launch the applications using the various Firefox OS simulators. And from here, you would be able to connect to devices and we'd be able to connect to devices in order to debug your applications. So Web IDE actually provides you a nice location with which to test across multiple devices. All right, so we'll close this. So, and another thing too is if you don't like the theme, we made it so that you can actually undo the theme. You can actually go into the settings there and you can turn off the theme and you end up back at the Australis, the regular light theme. What's very funny is from working on the developer tools, people have very strong opinions about what colors they are. So a lot of people really, really hate the dark theme, and a lot of people really hate the light theme. And even on my team, on the developer tools team, like it's like a very serious thing. So we've made sure to make it so that you can pick whichever one that you like. And what I want to say is that I think some people maybe also thought that this was going to be very, very different, like that we would introduce like hundreds of new features or tens of new features here, but we decided to start small. And the reason for this is because we want you to tell us what to do with this thing. We spend lots of time building developer tools, so you might think that, oh, well, if you spend lots of time with the developer tools, you probably know what developers want. But the thing is, I don't think we do. I think we spend so much time on these tools, but not doing the things that everyday web developers do, because I can tell you that working on the developer tools is definitely not the same workflow as someone building like a single page web application with a front end framework like Ember or something. You know, that's a different workflow than the people building the tools. It's very, very important to us that you tell us what you want. And so we thought, you know, we would show people this, and maybe if you're interested, please tell us what we should do with the developer edition. Everybody at Mozilla right now is very nervous because we don't know if you're going to like it. And the thing is, if you don't like it, tell us and we will make it into something that works for you. Our big goal here is that we want to actually help web developers, and we actually want you to be good at your job. And if we're doing it wrong, we want you to tell us, because sometimes I think we need that reality check. So this link here will take you to the Firefox Developer Tools User Voice panel. And this website allows you to submit features for Firefox, and in particular for the developer edition. And I think sometimes when companies ask me, they say, oh, Angelina, give us feedback and we'll change things. I think, no, you won't. You're going to ask me for my feature, and then I'm never going to hear from you again. But one of the things that I like about working at Mozilla and working with the developer tools team is that the feedback actually goes somewhere. When I started at Mozilla, I had some feedback for people working on the Firefox OS marketplace. And I expected, when I gave them the feedback, that I would never hear from them again. Because at so many companies, you give feedback, and someone says, okay, thanks. And then you never hear from them again. You don't know if that made a difference, so why bother? Why fill out the bug report if you're not going to feel like it's getting addressed? It just doesn't make sense. So, but when I remember back when I submit that feedback to the marketplace, 2 days later, someone emails me with revised designs for the thing I had a problem with, and I was like, oh, wow, you actually listened to me. And so the developer tools is very much that way. At this link, if you give feedback, myself and people who are making the feature and product decisions go through that, and we let your feedback tell us what is the priority. And you have my promise on that. We are very excited when you give us feedback there and give feature suggestions. Like, for example, we had, I think, one request where people really, really wanted implementations for I can't remember if it was object.observe. It might have been a JavaScript API. In any case, we check this very, very often, quite regularly. And this goes directly to the people that make those decisions for prioritization. So this is a good way for you to give feedback into Firefox. And without further ado, I must say, it's pretty impressive to me that we've gone from extension to being in the developer tools and now the entire browser. We are building a web for you, and we are building this browser for you. So please tell us what you like. You can come talk to me at the Firefox booth, or if you see me, I'm pretty friendly, but again, I don't speak Hungarian, so we have to work something out. And I'm more than happy to hear what you have to say about the browser and take that back to my team, because they are excited for that too. So thank you, and enjoy the conference from everybody at Mozilla.